9:45.
Yeah.
Oh. So cute.
Good boy.
Wow. Atlas. Atlas, hello. Hello, Atlas.
So this is our last half hour on the road before we get to the airport to drive out of America for 6 months. My lovely mom is driving us, and here's Belle. What are you thinking, Belle?
Well, I'm sad to say goodbye to everybody, but I am excited, and hopefully everything goes well. We don't get kidnapped to Belarus.
Mm. What's one thing you'll miss of California?
The dogs. I will miss our dogs quite a lot. We have great three little chihuahuas, so we're going to miss them a lot. And then we'd expect to be living on property with Kimmy when, you know, the college year ended, but because of coronavirus, we moved back there, and that was really fun. I never thought I'd come back and live at home, but it was really good.
What's the number one biggest thing you'll miss about being in America? Because you've been here basically nonstop for the last 5 years.
Yeah, of course, the obvious one is just like the actual people I know and care about. But second of all, the convenience of everything. I'm gonna miss having Daddy Bezos just like shipping me everything I need in 2 days' notice.
I like how as I'm talking about America, there's literally like 7 American flags that were just on that building behind us passing by.
That part, I don't think I'll miss as much.
What are you most excited about for our trip?
I'll be interested to see what the weather's like there. I think that'll be fun. I always like change of weather, especially in California. I feel like any change in weather is exciting. And I'm excited to see how blue the ocean will look.
That's a good one.
Yeah, and I'm mainly just excited though to walk around. I love like getting to know a place, but just wandering and walking. So I'm so excited just to like, okay, I get to like start to map out this place in my head and just wander around different streets and stuff like that. I feel like that'll be really fun.
What's the number one thing you're most excited about Europe for? Or Croatia at first?
Architecture. I just feel like I get such joy from looking at pretty things. I just want to walk around and admire everything.
What's the first thing you want to do when you get to Europe?
Pee.
What's something you're feeling nervous about?
I mean, for this flight coming up, I still have my arm in a sling, so I'm a little bit nervous just about like the physics of bringing everything and like getting things into overhead compartments. But I mean, that's just for the flight. I really have nothing that I'm scared about or nervous about for.
So. The last thing I was trying to say was I'm excited to try the food that's there. I'm not sure what food in Croatia will be like, but I'm excited for that.
I was curious about what the food is. Like, do they have the big lamb on a stick? The way
no, Mom, is? That's Greece.
Yeah, racism. Signing out. Say what you're saying.
And then we're going to be there.
Your attention, please. Federal
and local regulations require that all persons, including those vaccinated against COVID-19, properly wear a facial covering.
So they just gave us 2 beers and 2 cups of wine for free. And she actually handed us 2 beers, 2 cups of wine, and then she was handing us 2 additional beers. We said, no, we're okay. But they were about to give us like 4 beers and 2 wines for free.
So we're going crazy on this plane.
And the food is really good. It's a really good spicy pasta.
Yummy.
From the future now, coming in to tell you a little bit while we're on the plane of why we chose Croatia and basically what Croatia is, which sounds like a weird question to ask, but it is something that I've got a lot of people asking, which is like, what made us choose this country? First of all, I mean, we're post-college students, so we don't have that much money, so we were trying to figure out a country where our money would go further than it would in America. So that immediately ruled out places like France and Germany and even Italy to a certain point. Of course, Scandinavia is out of the question because those are some of the most expensive countries in the world. So it left us with some of the more recent EU countries, Croatia being one of them. Croatia was part of former Yugoslavia, up until it broke up in officially 1991, but at least for Croatia, they had a war from 91 to 95, and that finally ended with the country that we have today, which, despite there being that war, the country's in a good, safe, developed place now, because that was a good 20 years to 25 years ago at this point. And the Croatia of today is right across the coast on the Adriatic Sea of Italy. So it has some elements of Italian culture mixed with other like classically Balkan cultural elements. And we are in Tisno, which is in Dalmatia, which is the whole region of Croatia that is near the sea. And that area, the culture is way more similar to Italy. Whereas if you went way up more north, like where the capital of Zagreb is, that is where you're gonna get more of that classic Balkan culture. And where we are right now, where we're staying, is half on an island and half off. And you'll notice that there's a bridge that we're heading to right up there. And that is what connects us onto the island of Murter. Yeah, in general, it's just a very chill place, so we're enjoying it so far. And we will in later videos be explaining more and more about the history and some of the cultural differences between the US and Croatia. But as for now, this is just a little brief introduction. We'll get back to us on the plane. But if you have questions, feel free to leave them in the comments and we will be sure to answer them for next week's video.
Wow, I just saw you. I thought I just slept the whole night. I thought this flight was much longer, so I feel very well rested. I'm ready for a new day.
It's
6 p.m. You still got 6 hours in the day left.
Okay.
Party doesn't stop till the sun goes down.
Wait till the German woman.
Another happy landing. That's what Obi-Wan says.
Oh, cool.
You want to hit the lights? This is our first look at the apartment. So here's the bathroom.
And our own washing machine.
Oh my god, this is so cozy and colorful.
Oh my gosh, this is amazing. You know what this feels like? It feels like when you're a kid and like your parents make you like a little clubhouse where it's like this is your own zone. But like this is oh my gosh, look at this kitchen.
We're gonna play house.
Wow, and yeah, this literally looks, it literally looks like a playhouse.
Oh my god. And look at the view.
Belle, what's it like to be an adult?
I do taxes.
So fun. Wow.
It really goes to your shirt. Wow, Tom, do you want to be the first to see a bedroom?
Yes, I do. Wow. There they are.
Oh, that's awesome. They combined the beds for us. So we get one big bed instead of sleeping like Puritans. Wait, and for the first time in over a year, there's a door in our apartment so we can actually be in separate rooms if we need privacy.
Wow.
This is great.
Lonely Planet of Croatia, a classic.
Oh my god, I love that. It's my favorite book as a kid.
No, but do you know the Lonely Planet series?
No.
They're like the best travel guides. I'm legitimately going to read this.
Okay, me too. Okay. Fight me for it.
Oh, The Catcher in the Rye, a classic.
And April Love, so we can really feel like we're living our best life.
I feel like Catcher in the Rye is something good to read once a year.
Will that put you in the mood where you're enjoying yourself, or like?
No, actually, that I think that's actually my favorite book.
Hi. Oh. Oh my god, that's so awkward.
Okay, what are we doing? What are we up to? Apart from getting lost in the dark.
Wait, we're going the wrong way.
Okay.
Okay, so we just learned that apparently dinner is not a concept that exists in Croatia, but it is now 9:45 p.m. We've barely eaten all day because we've been flying all day.
So what are your impressions so far? You've been here all of what, 4 hours?
Yeah, and most of it was now after sunset in the backyard. So it was a nice backyard. That's what I can tell you at least.
Good morning, so welcome to day one or two, depending on how you want to look at it. So in terms of us getting on a better schedule with our jet lag, I thought I was doing pretty good. I woke up and I was like, okay, what time is it? 11 a.m. That's before noon. And then I asked Tom what time he woke up, and Tom, how long have you been up?
As of now, I've been up like around 5 hours.
Sorry, what? What time did you wake up?
Like 6:45.
You're way ahead of me in the game.
Yeah, well, I just felt, I woke up and I felt like, okay, I'm awake now. Yeah, so I walked to the little town area and got some pastries, half of which are for Berlin, and made some coffee. So listening to Johann Sebastian Bach to, you know, start the day off right. And yeah, I'm very allergic, so I've taken allergy medicine, but I think I'm a little bit behind the curve in terms of chasing the allergy, so I feel like my body's already reacting, so probably take a couple of days for me to get more used to it, hopefully. but...
That's our transition sound.
Yeah, but yeah, it's a beautiful day. Played with the dogs some. We've got a lot of unpacking to do. We can get more organized as the day goes on, but yeah, it's our first day here, so our main... okay, you're going a little Marty McFly there with your shaky hands. I think today the itinerary isn't very much. I think it's just kind of getting groceries, unpacking the stuff, getting organized, and just adjusting. You know, I think we're both a little bit groggy, sleepy, because in California time, right now it's like in the middle of the night. So I think our bodies are probably still adjusting, so I think we'll do the sightseeing and stuff in a couple of days once we're more adjusted. But, I mean, it's a beautiful day.